هيا على الفلاح.
So Allah Azza wa Jal says in these ayat, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Please listen to these ayat with open ears and take advantage of Ramadan, what's left. For you, for yourself, for your family's sake. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Allah will forgive all sins altogether. And it's the miracle of Qur'an, one of the great gifts of Qur'an, that Allah said ذُنُوب and didn't say سَيِّئَات. Because سَيِّئَات are bigger sins, ذُنُوب are lesser than that. And if you, Allah says, He'll even cover the small ones. Actually, the negation of the lesser includes the negation of the bigger. Like if Allah said, Allah will forgive your big sins, that would mean that He will leave the small sins. He says, I'll even take care of your smallest sins. I will wipe your slate so clean there won't be even a little stain. Everything will be gone. Jami'an. All of them altogether. إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. No doubt about it. He's the only one that is excessively forgiving. He's excessively forgiving. And He's always, always loving, always merciful, always caring. This is the first message that was supposed to be given about forgiveness. Allah is ready to forgive everything. Allah is ready to forgive everything. Allah is ready to start you fresh, completely new. But that is not the only thing. Someone just reads this ayah and thinks this is the message of the ayah. No, 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 no. Look, the awamir, the commandments continue. So the next ayah, the way to read it is, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَصْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ أَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ. It's like that, it's ma'tuf. What that means is, my slaves, now that you know I will forgive everything, then come back to me, come back to your master. That's the part two of this message. The discussion on forgiveness is not done yet. Come back to him. He says, I'm ready to forgive you, but my forgiveness isn't free. You have to do something to earn it. Come back to me. أَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ. Turn your hearts back to your master. You know, tawbah in Arabic can be literal too. Tawbah can be of the heart to turn back to Allah, but physically a person turning back is also a form of tawbah. Inaba is only for the heart. The word inaba is used in Arabic when the heart turns back to Allah. So Allah says, where's your heart? What are you obsessed with? What are you so distracted by? Turn back to your master. He's ready to forgive you. وَأَسْلِمُ لَهُ. And then He says, now that your heart has given up to me and has come back to me, then give yourselves up before Him. Be in Islam. Submit yourself. Be ready to obey. وَأَسْلِمُ لَهُ. مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَكُمُ الْعَذَابُ ثُمَّ لَا تُنصَرُونَ. Before punishment comes to you, then you won't be helped. Now Allah mentions punishment. So it's not like the ayat don't have punishment in them. They do. But where did they begin? They began with the offer, look, I'm ready to forgive everything. There is not going to be any punishment on you. But if you want it, you better turn back to me. And you better give yourself up before me. And you better do this quick. You better not think you have time. You better not be from the kinds of people that are told on judgment day, tarabbastum. You thought you had lots of time, so you could put it off. You know? It's like in the fi ma'na ta'akhartum. Like you put it off, more time maybe. Ranado. That sort of thing. Don't be like those people. Allah says, get to it min qabli. This min is called min at-ta'jeel. Right before punishment comes to you. I am telling you the punishment is not far. It is near. And if you're thinking of judgment day, some people think judgment day is so far away, right? إِنَّهُمْ يَرَوْنَهُ بَعِيدًا. They think it's so far away. وَنَرَاهُ قَرِيبًا. Allah says, we see that it's close. But for each one of us, when are we going to go? Are we even going to see the day of Eid? Who knows? Who knows when we're leaving? Who knows what Allah has written for the angel of death? Who knows if we're going to make it to the parking lot? Who knows? None of us know that. And when we go, مَنْ مَاتَ فَقَدْ قَامَتْ قِيَامَتُهُ. Whoever goes, whoever died, his qiyamah began. You don't have to wait for يوم القيامة, the day of resurrection, for your qiyamah. It's just a matter of a split second. And when the angel comes, he's not going to say, oh, I'm sorry, you have a meeting at 5 o'clock, let me come back. It's not going to be like that. It's when we're going to go, we're going to go. And there's not going to be any delaying. So Allah says, don't put this off. Don't put off your heart turning back to me and submitting yourself. وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ. By the way, the beauty of this in our religion is that if one decides that they're going to turn back to Allah sitting in a khutbah, they haven't even done anything yet. They haven't actually physically changed anything about their lifestyle. They haven't changed anything about the way they earn their money or the way they behave. They just made an intention in their heart they're going to be a different person. And as they were leaving, or before they could even enjoy seeing their family again, Allah decides to take them, they are forgiven. وَاتَّبِعُوا The commandments continue. Those of you that were in sin, وَاتَّبِعُوا أَحْسَنَ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُم مِّن رَبِّكُمْ It's so beautiful. Allah says, follow the best of what has been given to you. The best of what was sent down to you. What in the world does that mean? It means the Qur'an. There were revelations sent before. But the best of whatever has been sent to humanity is Allah's book. Nothing can be better than this. Why don't you follow it? Allah is telling us in this passage that the people who want to come back to Him, the road to come back to Him is His book and following it. And you can't follow a map that you don't understand. How do you follow a map and you don't know what the directions are? You and I have to have a direct relationship with this book. If you've been ignoring this book, then these ayat are for you. You and I want forgiveness, then we want a direct connection with the Qur'an. Recite it, try to understand what it's saying. Genuinely turn to Allah and say, Ya Allah, help me understand this book. I'm reading a translation I don't understand. Help me understand its explanation. Tell me what you mean. Ya Allah, make learning Arabic easy for me so I can connect with your book. Allah will make it easy for you. It's not like He won't. This is an open invitation to all of humanity. He said He'll make it easy. He did. I can't make that easy for you. Allah can. وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ We made Qur'an easy, He says. And He didn't say لِلْعَرَبْ. He made it easy for the Arabs. He made it easy for all humanity. That's His promise. Show Him some genuine incentive, some motivation on your side, that you're ready, that you want to come back. And you'll see that the doors start opening from Him. وَاتَّبِعُوا أَحْسَنَ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُم مِّن رَبِّكُمْ Follow the best of what has been sent. Meaning, you could never have received a better message, better advice, better counsel than this book. Jamb is right in Allah's company. You were close to a masjid. You used to come sit next to other Muslims, listen to advice from Allah's book. You used to listen to Qur'an being recited. You had family members that try to give you advice, and all of them were giving you closeness to Allah. The closeness to Allah, first of all, Allah Himself is near, فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ And second of all, those who reminded you of Allah, you kept pushing them off. Man, let me do what I'm doing, okay? Stop telling me what to do. Stop giving me, I don't need your advice. I'm good enough, I'm good. I don't need this sermon right here. This guy says, what have I done? How come I fell short? I could have done it. And then he gives the reason. Young people, please listen. He gives the reason why he fell short. He says, وَإِن كُنْتُ لَمِنَ السَّاخِرِينَ I used to be from the people that kid around. I thought all of it was a joke. I used to just, whatever. That was my attitude towards advice. Literally, sakhir. I didn't care. You know, there are people who lose hope in Allah's forgiveness. This ayah goes a step further. It's telling us about people who don't even care about forgiveness. They think it's a joke. Forgiveness for what? And what is Allah's response to all of them as I conclude my khutbah? Bala, no. On the contrary. The first guy that says, oh my God, I fell short. I'm so sorry. Yeah, your sorry is not good enough. The second guy that says, oh, if Allah only guided me, I would have been okay. Allah says, yeah, that's not going to fly here. Bala. Uh-uh. Ya Allah, if you just give me a second chance, I'm gonna be good this time. I got you. I'm going to take care of business this time. I'm going to take it very seriously. It's not going to be a joking matter to me now. Allah says, no. That time is over. I gave you a message that I will forgive everything and you didn't care. You kicked it to the curb. You spit at that invitation. You thought it was a joke. That's your fault. Allah says, Bala, قَدْ جَاءَتْكَ آيَاتِ My ayat came to you. And it's the singular. You know what that means? The revelation came to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Quran came to him, and through him it came to every one of you individually. Allah says, "Ja'atka ayati, ja'atka ayati, ja'atka ayat." My ayat came to you, and to you, and to you, and to you. And it's not even atatka ayati. It says, "Ja'atka ayati." Ja'a means coming from a long distance. I sent my Quran from the seventh heaven. I sent it with a legion of angels. To the final messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who bled so you can recite Quran one day. People died so we can recite Quran one day. People sacrificed their lives so there one day people will be saying La ilaha illallah and be opening this book and reciting the Fatiha. Those ayat came to you, فَكَذَّبْتَ biha, and you thought all of them were a lie? You ignored them? وَاسْتَكْبَرْتَ And you were filled with arrogance? You were arrogant to my message and my book? You dare ignore that message that came to you from all that distance? This is who you were? No, وَكُنْتَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ. You were a disbeliever all along. You could turn to Allah and cry that day all you want. This is the understanding of forgiveness. The ayat of Allah have come to all of us. This is the month we celebrate revelation. This is the month we get to say, Ya Allah, my ayat have come, your ayat have come to me, they've come to every one of us, and we are not going to be arrogant to them. We're not going to ignore them. Where's the happiness with the Qur'an? How are we people that Allah, the Messenger would call, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Ya Ahl al-Qur'an, people of Qur'an. People of Qur'an. Where is that? This is the time to fix it. Don't wait till tomorrow. Don't wait till tonight. Become people of the Qur'an. Become people that come closer to Allah and truly earn His forgiveness. And the guy is standing on Judgment Day, screaming out, Ya Allah, how could I have taken this not seriously? Why was this a joke to me? And then the second category of person, أَوْ تَقُولُ لَوْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ هَدَانِي. The second category of person says, oh, if only Allah guided me. It's Allah in fact. If He guided me, لَكُنْتُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. I would have been from the people of taqwa. Allah decided that I should be a party animal. Allah decided I shouldn't pray. Allah decided I should be lazy. Allah decided I should have an anger problem. You know how to make other people responsible for what they do, but when it comes to yourself, you say, no. Allah decided I should do bad things. Really, you hypocrite? This is how you're going to be? This is the excuse you're going to hide behind? And he's still saying it on Judgment Day. I would have been a muttaqi if Allah guided me. Allah decided not to guide me. This is all predestination. أَوْ تَقُولْ حِينَ تَرَى الْعَذَابِ لَوْ أَنَّ لِي كَرَّةً. When he sees the punishment, he says, okay. Fine, it is my fault. I admit. When he sees the punishment. If you just give me a second chance, لَوْ أَنَّ لِي كَرَّةً. If I had a second chance, فَأَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. I would be from not just Muslim, not just mu'min, I would be from the muhsineen. What is the definition of a muhsin? You worship Allah as though you can see Him. Now that he sees punishment, he goes, I'll worship Allah as though I see the punishment. I'll have ihsan. I'm ready. Ya Allah, just send me back. I'm going to be so good. I'm just ready to change now. Just one more chance. You know, you're Ar-Rahman. You give me a chance. These are the people that talk. These are the excuses they make. Because they had false understandings of what it means to be forgiven.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. If you enjoyed this video, please do share it with friends and family. If you want to see more videos from this series, click on the box at the top. If you want to see other videos, click on the box at the bottom. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks.